Okay, next. Ah, I love this one. I love this one because I don't know, some of you may not know this. I used to be a tour guide. I used to be a historian in Egypt, Jim, before becoming that whoever I am now. I don't know what they call that. Seriously, and subhanAllah, I'll never forget this day, Ikhwa, because I went to school for 5 years to study Egyptian history. Imagine, never in any of the textbook they told us about Yusuf, Musa, and Bani Israel. Never the name Moses or Bani Israel was mentioned in any of the textbook. Imagine this. Because really the Egyptians were the bad people. And Bani Israel were what? Were the Muslims, were the good people at the time. See, they want to teach you history. That's where, you know, the curriculum can mess up generations. So, subhanAllah, I got graduated. This is off. I'm done with it. If you want to go. But this is a story that I know that you would like to listen to. I'm done. It's over. But listen to this. Subhanallah, I get graduated, Jim, from college. And the first job I get, a company based in New York called Christian Tours. And it has a branch in Bavaria, in Germany, Obermargau, that's the name. I used to speak German too, or I do, I mean, I still do, but it's, I don't practice. Called Christliche Reisen. What is the story here? The priest and the rabbis, they form their own church groups. And they come to visit the Holy Land in Israel. Then they cross the border to Sinai. They go to the mountain where Prophet Musa spoke to. Then I bring them to Egypt for one day to see the pyramids. And then I take them to the airport. I used to do this for 2 years. So I go to the border I call it Palestine. And I receive the group. By this time they visited Jerusalem, they visited the Holy Land there. And then I would take them to the mountain where Prophet Musa alayhi salam supposedly spoke to Allah. We would wake up at 1 o'clock in the morning and would we climb this mountain. By the time we get there, the sunrise. It's a huge mountain. And then we come down and they visit the monastery in St. Catherine Monastery. Then I would take them to Egypt to visit the pyramids and do some tour there. And then the Jewish rabbis and the priest, the Christian priest. These are guys who are what? A lot of them are what do you call evangelish, the like the Salafi kind of Christians. The Salafi Christians. So they come to me and they say, the Jews built the pyramids. Who'd say this? And I get so mad. And we had that Egyptian thing, they raised up with that thing, this subhanAllah, all this stuff is fake, man, wallahi, subhanAllah, is like, but they brainstorm you, they wash you. It's like here, they wash the young kids do not to believe in God, So the Egyptians built the pyramids. And I get so mad at the guy. No, that's the only thing left for us. I mean, that's the one thing that I stand out there. The Egyptians built the pyramids, and I explain it. I said, no, the Jews built the pyramids, not the Egyptians. I said, wallahi, and this would happen almost as if they talk to one another, everyone. And wallahi, ya ikhwa, I remember these days, I would go back to the textbook that I studied in college, Rasul. There is no mention of Jews, anything. They removed all of this from the books. I used to live by the pyramids. I used to have a flat by the pyramids. So I get on that taxi. I deliver this guy, this group. And then I stop the taxi. And I found this, taxi driver, Muslim. His beard is huge. And he's playing the Quran in his radio. So I'm sitting in the back and my blood still boiling because that rabbi just told me that the Jews built the pyramids and I'm trying to overcome it, it's like. And then this guy, man, he Al-Minshawi, wallahi, I'll never forget this day, wallahi, as if it's yesterday. Al-Minshawi. And then, Ta-Si-Mim. It's the first time as if I hear the Quran. تلك آيات الكتاب المبين نتلو عليك من نبأ موسى وفرعون بالحق لقومي. Just go home and listen to المنشاوي سورة القصص and you'll know what I'm telling you. Allah, the Quran is telling me that Musa was in Egypt and the Pharaoh enslaved the Muslims, the Bani Israel, and they threw him in the river and he was picked up. I said, man, this was in Egypt. What happened to the textbook? How come it's not in the textbook? Wallah, at this day, ikhwa, I started feeling betrayed that you're a victim of a curriculum that you can't even, you know. You see, at this time there was that 73 war, 67 war, so they are trying to get us to hate the Jews and the Jews, anybody's Jews, you know, not the Zionists, but the Jew completely. They brainstormed you in a way. They orchestrated that. Yeah. But one of the interesting things here, and this is where the argument here, there was a reference in Egypt to Egypt in the Quran during the time of Musa and during the time of Yusuf. Why the ruler during the time of Yusuf was called the king and the ruler during the time of Moses was called the Pharaoh? That's a title, by the way, like president now. We call president, or, you know, it's a title. Why? And how did the Prophet ﷺ knew about this? When Napoleon Bonaparte, the French general, conquered Egypt, he brought with him a group of scientists. They discovered what is known to be a Rosetta Stone. Even if that's they use it here. What is a Rosetta Stone? You're able to read the hieroglyphic language and understand it. At this time, by the way, there was no access. And that's why they started discovering these mummies and all that after finding out that Rosetta Stone, because that Rosetta Stone had that what this sign stands for, that you can actually read now what's written in the walls and you can translate history now. Egypt during the time of Yusuf was invaded by a force in the east called the Hyksos. Imagine this. And the ruler was called the king. This happened, by the way, 200 years ago. Bonaparte is 200 years ago. We're talking about this was revealed when? 1400 years ago. How did the Prophet know about this? But during the time of Musa, the Pharaoh restored they kicked these guys out. And the reason why they enslaved Bani Israel, the children of Israel, because they believed that children of Israel helped the occupier. You're getting it? Because Yusuf held Egypt, helped these guys with his plan, and that's why he said, you know what, these guys, they helped the occupier, let's enslave them. That's one of the reasons, yeah. But this is again another thing that shows you that the Quran is not something that is what? لا. وَإِنَّكَ لَتُلَقَّى الْقُرْآنَ مِنْ لَدُنْ حَكِيمٍ عَلِيمٍ. جَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. I rest my case. Next surah is very short. It's going to be done in a half hour. Called the thunder. The thunder. The thunder. Beautiful. جَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.